What's up, everyone? I'm Kirsten Johnson, the Renaissance Woman, and welcome to my show. Today, we're discussing your tenants' rights, so make sure you listen up and pay attention. So before we get into discussing what the laws are regarding your tenants' rights, let's actually discuss what tenants' rights are. What does that mean? It means that you, as a tenant, as a renter, whether it be you're renting from a private owner or from a luxury apartment building, wherever you may live, you have rights. You have rights about your living conditions. You have rights about what should be done. You are entitled to be taken care of in a way that is comparable to what you are receiving throughout your building. If you're paying that rent on time, those people better make sure that you're being taken care of. Point blank, period. Now, during the pandemic, a lot of us found ourselves displaced. A lot of us found ourselves in positions where we weren't able to pay our rent on time, if at all. Don't worry, the law got your back, if you know how to utilize it. Remember, as a tenant, you have rights. As a landlord, so do they. So, let's go over some of your rights. In most states throughout the country, you are required to have running water, hot running water, clean running water, air conditioning, and heat. That's just the bare minimum. Most of us obviously need water. We need water to clean our dishes. We need water to clean our clothes. We need water to clean ourselves. So let me tell you about an issue that I personally experienced with one of my living situations. I was living in a building where, for some reason whatsoever, beyond what I know, my water completely turned off. Now, obviously, I know that this is something that's regarding my tenants' rights. Not only is this a violation of my tenants' rights, it's a violation of the building. How can you not provide your tenant with hot water or running water at all? Experiencing something like this, one of the first things you have to do is contact your landlord. Paper trail, paper trail, paper trail. If they can collect your money without any issue, they can get things fixed for you without any issue. Now, I had an issue, and this went on for well over a week. So, emailed them, no response back. I emailed them again, still, no response. So, after two emails and me leaving a paper trail, clearly citing what my issue was, I took it to the next level, Better Business Bureau. The Better Business Bureau is one of your best friends when it comes to complaints and holding businesses accountable. Now, 9 times out of 10, it's best for a refund, but if that's not gonna work for you and you're not looking for a refund, take it even higher. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take it to HUD, HUD, the Housing Urban Development of your state. These people got your back. These people gonna make sure what needs to get done is gonna get done. So for me, what I did was I let them know what my issue was. And me being me, guess who got a nice little fat cut on their rent? I did. In this country, one of the things that I've felt and completely noticed time and time again is we always feel like going the extra mile to get things done for our rights that we're due, that we shouldn't have to complain about or run after. It's too much work to get done. That's nonsense. I'm gonna write that damn letter. I might have to be a little caring about it, and I'm gonna go and do it because it gets shit done. Go the extra mile to make sure that the things that you need, the things that you deserve, and the things that you're legally entitled to get done, because nobody else is gonna do it for you. So running and hot water, basic. So as a tenant, no matter what state you're in throughout this country, ask yourself, is your landlord giving you and keeping up their end of the bargain in the same way that you are?